And now to a marriage of science and art, on stage and in real life, from a leading playwright and a pioneering researcher into the causes and effects of pandemics. Jeffrey Brown has the story for our ongoing arts and culture series, Canvas.
What is it?
A play in the time of pandemic, about how pandemics happen.
I try to predict pandemics. Because if you can predict pandemics, you just might be able to prevent them.
A story of a scientist thrilled by discovery.
Bacteria and viruses are the same thing. No, no, absolutely not. They are vastly different.
And pained by loss. It's called The Catastrophist, playwright Lauren Gunderson.
It was a story that I knew I could tell, but the question was, should you?
The reason? The subject is her husband, Nathan Wolfe.
But it felt like now is an obvious time to go into the backstory, the passion behind scientists who study what Nathan studies in virology, pandemic experts.
And how did the subject himself feel?
The truth of the matter is, if you're married to one of the most prolific playwrights in the world, especially someone who focuses on science, you learn that the various characters in her plays, you shouldn't extrapolate too much or see yourself in those characters. Now, of course, I had to change my viewpoint a little bit for this particular play.
Wolf, now 50, is a virologist, known for his work tracing how viruses jump from animals to humans. He worked in Africa for many years and was on Time magazine's 2011 list of 100 most influential people. That same year, he was featured on the NewsHour after his book, The Viral Storm, The Dawn of a New Pandemic Age, predicted the kind of event we're living through now. 39-year-old Lauren Gunderson is prolific and successful. According to the trade magazine American Theater, she's the most produced playwright in the country, with many works that explore science and scientists of the past. She wrote The Catastrophist during the pandemic, commissioned by Marin Theater in California, directed by its artistic director, Jason Minadakis, and co-produced with Roundhouse Theater in Maryland.
Prokaryotes.
Actor William Demerit plays a character besotted with science and the search for the unknown.
We made the decision that this is not an imitation of Nathan, it's an artistic synthesis. But I also can say that it absolutely is true that Nathan is besotted with science. I can confirm that that is true.
Gunderson and Wolf live in San Francisco and have two young sons. The play delves deeply into Wolf becoming a father while losing his own, a man obsessed with mapping future catastrophes while unable to foresee those in front of him.
How does the futurist not see his own future? How does the catastrophist not plan for his own catastrophe?
It's a personal story, but also for Gunderson and her collaborators about the power of art, especially now.
We believe in theater. We believe it never stops. We believe it's necessary, especially in times of crisis. We believe in science. We believe that the stories of science and scientists lift up new heroes. We believe in empathy and how that is a unifying force, and it happens to be one of theater's superpowers.
Wolf's focus these days is assessing the risks of pandemics. His company creates models for government agencies and corporations to help mitigate potential damage. Of course, as a recent cover story on him in Wired magazine suggests, we humans aren't very good at planning ahead. I asked if anything about this pandemic has surprised him.
In some ways, what is unexpected is the nuance, the small features, you know, that you won't model. You know, the impact of Twitter, the way that communication and miscommunication has played a role.
Still, he says,
I tend to be an optimist, and let's just say it this way, I no longer have to spend the first 10 minutes when I'm talking to somebody, you know, the CEO of a large corporation, explaining the potential impact of pandemics.
In their own personal lives, Gunderson and Wolf say their work as writer and scientist feeds the other. And they see a deeper connection in the disciplines.
Science and art are a lot closer than they are often portrayed, because at the heart, you are trying to innovate, you are trying to investigate, you are trying to create.
And I think people they think of scientists in a particular way, laboring in a lab, but at its fundamental core, science is attempting to understand features of the universe. And in order to sort of really make important strides in science. You have to see something and be willing to believe something which others don't. And that's the part of science that I love.
See, he makes a great character.
Now you see a character you could use in a play?
See, I love it. This is what I write about. No wonder I kept waking up next to a character and it took me 10 years to write it.
As the character in the play says,
it's a risk being married to a playwright. They usually get the last word.
The Catastrophist is streaming through February 28 by the Roundhouse and Marin Theater Companies.
But viruses.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown.
We can't link them to us because...
It's fascinating.